Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, Artcast 563 or 4, one of those two. So what do you guys think? Shaved it up. I don't know. I was going to actually just shave it all off, but then, I don't know, I shaved it down to this, and I thought, this looks kind of cool. My wife already told me she don't like it, though, so it might not stay. Anyway, let's do some art. Let's do some drawing. So today I'm working on something a little different. I need to get commissions done. You know what I mean? It's like I don't just draw the comic all the time. So this is a commission for a guy. I felt like I needed to make a video with it because I wanted to just make sure that he saw I was working on it. I didn't want him to think I was just blowing it off still. And yeah, it's a Daenerys with like the three dragons. And it's coming out pretty good. I'm working through the drawing and then sort of like blacking it in with black acrylics right now. And so I think it's coming out pretty good. I'm painting this one on wood also. I went back to MDF. For a while I was doing these more realistic ones on paper. And then I would mount it on board, you know, after I sold it. But I don't know, there's something I like about drawing on board, and then there's parts that I don't like. I think paper's like made to draw, you know. It's sort of like you've got, you know, hundreds of years of perfection making like that perfect surface to draw on. But what I kind of like about just painting straight onto wood is it's like, I guess it feels very permanent. It feels, you know, it's like a heavy piece when somebody buys it. And I like that aspect of it, you know. On all my comic book stuff, I just draw on paper though, because I just don't really want a big stack of boards in my house, you know. And there's so many pieces when you're drawing a comic that are just sort of like a hand turning a doorknob or somebody, you know, somebody's feet walking down an alley or something that really nobody's ever going to want to buy. They're never going to want to stick it up on their wall. So it seems kind of like overkill to like throw that stuff onto board. This board here, I actually didn't gesso. Just painting on it raw. I have experimented both ways with this. Of course, painting on it raw kind of gives it that natural brown color to start off with, which can be a benefit and kind of a drawback at times, depending on like where you're going with this. This piece is going to kind of have like a reddish type sunset breaking into a blue sky. And then the dragons are all sort of going to be tinted different colors, red, yellow, blue. And then, you know, of course her, she's, you know, mainly yellow, whites, you know, light skin. So like with her, it all works. I don't know. I like to experiment though. It just kind of makes me realize, like, you know, as many pieces as I've done, you know, there's so many pieces on like different stuff, and I'm still just trying to figure out like what I like, and you know, what I like today might be not what I like in 2 years from now. So it just evolves, you know. I think that's just art. You're always like learning. You're always kind of striving to get to the next stage, and that's how it's supposed to be, you know. I think it would get really boring if you woke up tomorrow and just said, "Ah, I have all the answers," you know. You'd probably want to go learn something that you don't know how to do. I wanted to mention, though, I had kind of a nice surprise today when I went to my YouTube channel. I don't know if you guys have noticed yet, but underneath this video, there should be, at least, there is for me, a bar that has some t-shirts on it. Now, with YouTube, like when you get to 10,000 subscribers, they let you have a merchandise bar on your channel. And for quite a while now, I've been over 10,000. I think I'm up around 15 now. And, you know, it's a merchandise bar that you can sell stuff from a specific site. So you can only sell stuff from Teespring. And I didn't really have anything in Teespring or at least I didn't think I did. The other day I was kind of looking at, you know, the YouTube notifications that they give you sort of in the back end of like in the studio and stuff like that. And they sent me another one saying, "Oh, you should set up your merch, you know." I just hadn't done it yet. I just hadn't had time to kind of deal with it yet. But at any rate, I logged into Teespring just to kind of see what the deal was, what I was going to have to do to make a t-shirt and all that kind of stuff. And I forgot, I actually did make at least one t-shirt on Teespring. And that's this one that you can see down below. It's like the Hulk yelling. That's from one of my paintings, you know, a commission I did for a guy. And, I was looking at it and I thought, that's a pretty good design. I might as well just like, you know, let it go live with that and see what happens. And so that's what's on there. That's what's actually on there right now. let me know if you guys can see like the bar and stuff. And you know, I don't know if anybody wants to buy one, but you know, if you do, there it is. And I was also thinking, like, I throw out the question, like, what do you guys think I should do for as far as like some more t-shirts? Because I probably should just go ahead and make some more t-shirts. And I was kind of thinking about maybe making a t-shirt from some of my like monster stuff, like Dracula and Frankenstein. And then I've got some like cowboy stuff, mainly like Clint Eastwood paintings that I've done that have been like really good sellers as far as prints go. And so I might go ahead and try that in the next couple weeks. And then of course I want to make a Berserkonaut shirt. I want to make a Frankenborg shirt with like pieces of them and the logo on it and stuff like that. But yeah, pretty cool. I'm interested to see if it'll actually do anything, you know? I've had so many people tell me in the past that, like, I should be doing t-shirts, I should be doing mugs, I should be on all these places like, you know, Cafe Press and Zazzle and all these places. And, you know, I've experimented with those places, but I've never, you know, really noticed stuff selling, you know, as well as, like, what I can just sell myself, you know, like the prints that I make here. And sell, you know, directly. Those always seem like they sold like a ton better than those sites. And then, you know, it always kind of worried me a little bit, like quality control, you know, it's like, cause you don't really know what's going out as far as like what's going in the package, you know, like I can control that here, but like, you know, you're trusting the sites to do a good job and to ship on time and to do what they're supposed to do. So at any rate, there you go. Check it out. Let me know what you think. I want to know that more than anything. Just like, what's your guys' thoughts on t-shirts? I don't know if you've ever bought Teespring shirts before. But yeah, just fill me in with like the info you guys got, because this is like a whole new thing for me. And even though I just said, you know, I never had much luck with those sites, it's like this is like a new way to sell, which is YouTube videos. And YouTube videos in the past have always sold stuff for me, you know. Whether it's commissions, prints, whatever, eBay auctions, I've always had really good luck selling stuff that I show or do on YouTube. So that's it for today, guys. I'll see you next week. The Berserkonaut's still over at Indiegogo InDemand. In fact, I got to package one up right now and get it to the post office before it closes. The mailing list is down in the description. Sign up for that mailing list if you'd like me to send you a notification every time I do a new video. And also Patreon, hit me up, you know, sign up for Patreon if you guys want to support the videos and help me make more videos. Thanks a lot. I'll see you next time.